together for the original French fry, Joan of Arc. Woo!
Yes, yes.
Sorry, I was a little bit late. I just lost the roast battle. I'm a little nervous. It's pretty high stakes in here. As he said, I'm Joan of Arc. I know a lot of you know me from the name I was given after defeating the English in the Siege of Orleans. They like to call me the Maid of Orleans. That's how most of you would know this guy. This always happens. You know me from the other thing, right? Some of you might know me from the other thing on spring break, that movie, The Maid of New Orleans. It's a mistake. What can I say? A lot of people ask me, Joan, you're almost 19 years old. Why aren't you married already? And honestly, you know, a lot of guys have taken a chance at romancing the Joan, but I swear to God, if I have to hear one more guy do a shitty pickup line, like, ooh, I like my women the way I like my coffee, French roasted, I'm gonna fucking light myself on fire! I was engaged for a little while. This is a little known historical fact. I was engaged to one of the generals in the French army during the siege. And he was so sexy. He had this, it was his voice. His voice did it for me. He had this like deep, hoarse French accent. Just this hoarse French accent. Like, darling, can you pass the wine? S'il vous plaît. No, that was an ant. Yeah, you gotta use something. Oh yeah, I was on the answer. Okay. But he was totally into me. He was so into me. He was almost too needy. He was asking for me 2 or 3 times a day. And like, if I wasn't around, he got all annoying about it. And one time I went over to his tent on the battlefield and started digging through his stuff. I found all these books and stories and pictures of Andromeda, Athena, Cleopatra. It turns out this guy was just a heroin addict. Yeah, I know. That's what happens when you kill 2 birds with 1 Joan. Oh. Oh, come on! I'm a fucking saint! they're not liking the artichokes. No. He says I should do the other artichoke. Okay. You didn't like the first artichoke. Okay, you know, like, okay, all these historical figures were coming into town, you know, none of us are actual comedians. Henry VIII admitted to using ghostwriters, and I'm only using one second ghostwriter, okay? The Holy Ghost! Did you hear this though? There's this guy in Kentucky, and he is recreating the Ark. Yeah, he's recreating it to the exact standards of the Bible, and he's building it, biblical era tools, and it's gonna be exactly like Noah's. And he's calling it Clone of Ark. And I'm sorry to tell you, but actually we're not gonna be able to visit it for a while because he ran out of money and he went to the bank and he got it declined for a loan of Ark. Okay, I'm on my own. So later in the evening, I don't know if this is a spoiler, but I met him backstage. We've got Pierre Marquette coming out. Yeah? Ooh, yeah. I'm a big fan. French Pride, let's go. I know my accent's super French. I heard they have my chapel there. They've got the Joan of Arc Chapel. And you know, it's really beautiful. If you haven't been there, I recommend checking it out. They're not paying me to say that. But I had a huge problem with the dress code, because these Marquette girls, they were wearing these tight little black leggings and just letting it all hang out there in my chapel. I just disagree with it. I strongly disagree with visible pantyline. No, maybe not everybody knows this. Not everybody knows. A lot of people think I got burnt at the stake for like talking to God in my head. But the thing is, they couldn't actually nail me on those charges. So they got me with the charge of cross-dressing. This is a true story. I was burned at the stake. Thank you for reading. Thank you for reading all the books about me. I'll autograph all of them after the show. I'm just kidding. I'm illiterate. Bet you didn't know that. So I was actually crucified. That's coming up later in the show. I was burned on the charge of cross-dressing because I was wearing pants to defend myself from rapists. Now, rape jokes aren't funny, so I'm not going to tell them. But what happened was I was still wearing them under my dress, and I thought I could get away with it, but they saw it. Fucking saw it, and so I got burnt alive for visible pant line. Not only is VPL a crime against fashion, it is a crime against the Lord. So watch yourself. I saw you walk in here. That on my notes, it says, point to a woman in the front row, any woman. I've been here for a little while. I'm super excited about being in the 21st century television. Woo! Yeah. Oh, you all just take it for granted.
I'm loving watching it.
Yeah. Henry Gensky, TV. This shit is off the hook, guys. Losing myself in it. I spent 7 days on the couch. I don't think I even got up once because Discovery Channel had Joan of Shark Week. Okay. American TV, so much better than French TV. American movies are so much better than every French movie. So I'm gonna leave you with this. I'm gonna leave you with this. That sounded like a good idea on the car ride over. Okay, but anyways, I did fight in the Siege of Orleans, and I spent a lot of time with the soldiers on the battlefield, helping the French army. I gained the trust of King Charles, and then King Charles asked me if I would report back to him. Since I was so close with all the generals, he asked me if I would report back to him on which one of his generals were drinking alcohol and using the poppy. I was like, who does he think I am? Joan of Arc?
Oh!
Bare Knuckle Comedy.